If you find the content relevant, then do like, share and subscribe to the channel. Also hit the bell button to get a regular notification. Also do share your experiences and any suggestions that you have in the comment box. Hope you enjoyed.
Hi, so looking at how to practice the DLR section. So we finished the syllabus, and once the syllabus is over, what do you need to do so that you can be good at the DLR section? So before we look at what we need to do, let's look at what is important for practice. What should we focus on when we practice? First is look at more non-traditional sums, because what comes in the examination is not traditional sums. Traditional sum is like the matrix-based sum, or the arrangement sums. But if you look at what comes in the examination, the very non-traditional sums, which is normally a mixture of two or three kind of topics put into one and then given it to you as a sum. So that means, and it also makes you think, because every time the sums are different that comes in the exam, which means I need to build on my thinking ability. So I need to think. So what I'm trying to focus out here is purely on DLR section in terms of how to practice. To build up your base, you obviously need to solve puzzles and do other things. But let's look at how to solve more non-traditional sums. First important aspect, and that is more important in DLR section than anything else, is selection of questions. Because if you by chance select a wrong question and end up solving it, there's a chance that you may waste a lot of time. Okay, so that means selection of question becomes extremely important as far as DLR is concerned. So the first part that you need to is practice selection of questions, correct selection of questions. Also to work on, I mean, what are other areas that you need to work on? One is how to read effectively. I mean, what does it mean? Like DLR is normally a passage or a long thing that you need to read. A lot of students, they end up reading the whole set twice and thrice before they actually solve, or maybe four times at least. And that wastes a lot of time. Also, if you don't read effectively, what happens, unfortunately, is you don't understand properly. You miss out of a small sentence, you lose out something. So focus on how to read effectively. You need to be able to read that effectively. If by chance you're not able to comprehend, try to do better. So I also know maybe a person who was able to read the whole set once and able to solve it effectively. I mean, he tried. So he used to initially read twice or thrice a particular set before he used to solve. He ensured that he practiced such a way that he read the whole set once, putting the data properly and getting the answer. So you have your own ways of doing it, but ensure that you don't waste too much time on reading. And you don't do a lot of mistakes while reading, two important things while reading, and that will lead to reading effectively. Second and next important thing while working on, while solving, is representing data in a proper format. So if you don't represent in a proper format, one thing, it will take a longer time to get the answer. Second, you yourself will be confused with the data. The key in a LRDI sum is to represent the data in proper format and interpret it properly. But if you don't represent the data, and your interpretation will obviously go wrong. So representing it proper formats are very important, and knowing what for proper formats for different kind of sums will what help you better. Identifying the starting point. So we put the data properly, where to start from. So again, people start thinking about it. You need to be very clear where to start from. So normally you start from where a lot of data is given to you, or normally you start from where is specific information given to you. You need to know for different kind of sums, how do you start the sum? You should not waste a lot of time starting. Okay, so these are two third area which I'm talking about. Fourth area is actually process of solving itself. I mean, the whole calculation process, how do you solve, etc. So these are the four areas that you need to work on while solving. Okay, so a lot of people do mistakes in one of these areas, either reading or representing data or identifying the starting, where to start from, or the actual solving itself. Check out where you waste a lot of time and start working on that area. That becomes very important. And apart from that, a very effective way for solving is taking help of questions to solve. Suppose you don't get the answer, you try to solve a set, you don't get the answer. Go to the questions and see if you can get some hint from the questions to get the answer. Or it's possible that from the whatever data you solve, you may be able to solve few of the questions that are there given to you, and few may not. So work on the question, try to look at the hint from the questions to solve the sum. It helps sometimes. Also, when you work from the questions, it also helps you when there's less time in the exam. For example, you have only 5 minutes and you know you can't solve a whole set. Then maybe you can work from the questions and then try to solve the sum. That is also an effective way of solving. So using the help of options to get the answer quickly could help. So how to actually practice? So what are we working on is how do you actually put into practice? First is source. Obviously, the past CAT papers are a good source and the DLR sets from the mocks are a good source. So look at these sources and try to practice. The old CAT papers will have a little different kind of DLR sets. The newer CAT papers are more relevant. If you have not solved them, you can solve them. Or you can look at various mocks and try to pick up a DLR sets from there and try to solve. That should help you to practice better. When you start a DLR set, practicing a DLR set, spend at least 1.5 minutes in the start just to decide whether a set is easy, medium or tough. So I take a set, I read it for 1 minute or 1.5 minutes and mark it. This set looks easy or this set looks medium. Because this is what you'll do in the mocks also or in the exam also. You will spend that 1 minute approximately to decide whether a set is tough or easy or medium. And you should be able to do this. So during this time, you can even start solving it, madam. When you approach it, you should approach as if you're going to try to solve it. But should be able to make out when 1.5 minutes whether I should leave it or not. Right? So that is very important in this. Next, solve it. I mean, following the whole process of putting the data properly, starting, solving the whole process. Use the whole process. Take 10 to 12 minutes to solve the whole set as far as possible. If you're not able to solve it in 12 minutes, it makes sense to look at the explanatory answer. Right? So first, try with your own method, try to solve. Check the solutions. Is there a better method in the solution or to understand the sum better? Look at the solution as such. Then go back to the set and check. Have you read the set properly, effectively? Did you waste a lot of time in solving? Did you represent the data properly in a proper format? Or was there a mistake in that? Or could you have represented data better? Did you start effectively? The moment you read the set, you knew where to start and you started. Or did you waste a lot of time in starting? Or was the solving process very clear? Or again, did you waste a lot of time in, you know, doing wrong solving and then coming back, etc. So figure out which are the areas that you need to improve among these four and try to work on that. And that will come when you analyze after you solve a set, going back and checking out where are you doing it wrong. And then obviously working on that. Check whether you're marking the initial easy, medium, tough that you marked. Was it correct or not? So you started with easy, medium, tough. Remember, it is the most important part. Go back and check. After solving, whether whatever you marked was easy, so was it easy, was it medium, was it tough? If it is not, then rectify your selection parameters. You should always have a particular paper or book where you write down what are the parameters on which you select. Oh, too long a set, maybe I'll leave it. Oh, it's a complicated matrix-based sum with 6 variables, maybe I'll leave it. So you need to have some idea regarding which are the sets you'll solve, which are the sets you'll leave. Sets maybe with F or sets with maximum, minimum, maybe I'll leave. Sets which are of particular type I will solve. So you need to have idea. That doesn't mean you'll definitely leave the set. You still spend 1 minute on the set. But these parameters will help you to, you know, judge. Normally I say when you approach a set, don't go with a preconceived mind idea as far as possible. Try to be open because sometimes what we feel is tough. I mean, a lot of people say if there's an if industry question, you should leave it because it could be tough. But there are a lot of easy questions with the if in the question. And I need not leave it. So therefore at 1 minute per set, you should go to it and try to figure out what. So find out what works, what doesn't work, what makes a set tough, what makes a set easy. Over a period of time, as and when you keep on practicing, your selection parameter should be good. You should be able to select the set properly. And in the end, try forming patterns to solve different types of sets. For example, I know in a matrix set, I know how to solve. I put columns, put all the variables on top, and try to put a data one below the other. Same with arrangement, I know how to solve. But when you solve DLR sets, you have different kind of sets that come across. So for what some common type of elements, try to work on forming patterns. That should help you better. I hope this helps. Try to work on this. Try to see if you can work on this DLR practice. Normally DLR is one area which, you know, improves with practice. I mean, other like mathematics and verbal takes a little longer to improve. DLR takes a little shorter time to improve with practice. So practice. And that should help you to improve. Hope this helps. Thank you.